SwiftUI environments are amazing because they allow you to share data effortlessly across your entire app, ensuring consistency and simplifying state management. With just a few lines of code, you can pass data through multiple views without cluttering your codebase, making it cleaner and more maintainable. In this video, you will learn how to create your own custom environment, unlocking even more flexibility and control for your SwiftUI projects. By the end, you'll be able to streamline your app's data flow like a pro. Till Halloween, I'm having a special offer on mentoring sessions. Buy one, get one free. So if you pay for one mentoring session, you are going to get two of them. Or if you pay for two mentoring sessions, you are going to get 4 hours of mentoring sessions with me. The link is going to be down in the description. So today we are going to talk about environment keys, what they are, why they are so powerful in SwiftUI, and I'm going to go step by step explaining the path to using environment keys, and it's going to be really, really powerful. So I have just prepared here a starter Xcode project. SwiftUI environment key is the name, and as you can see, I did not change anything. It's just the globe and the hello world. Now, let's just assume that we want to have kind of an example like presenting a sheet, and that would be inside a button. So let's just have, well, I'm just going to remove all of the clutter. Let's just have that button and then sheet. And then on the action, we would, you know, we're going to get there in just a second. But for now, let's just add that sheet view modifier. And then is sheet presented? We need to bind it. And let's just create that state variable right over here. At state private var is presented bool equals false. So I can just bind it over there. And the content, a text. Sheet. There we go. It's just a sheet. And how will you trigger it? Is presented dot toggle. Most probably like 99% of you guys already know this. Let's check it out so you know we can see that what we have over here is just actually a working sheet. It's just presenting a sheet. Nice and dandy. Now let's take this a little bit further. Let's move this is presented into a view model. Let's just create our content view model right over here. So class, let's just have this as a content view model. There we go. An observable object. We are going to have a published variable. Well, let me just copy this out and paste it into there. And instead of state private, we want to have a published var is presented equals false. So now what we are going to do is use this instead of the state variable. So how do we do that? Well, we want to initialize it at state object private var view model content view model. Well, I'm going to initialize it just like this equals content view model. Of course, you can have that as an environment object. We are going to get there soon. But for now, here we have our view model. And then I'm just going to say view model is presented.toggle and then $ view model dot is presented for the sheets binding. And let's just build and run. And then let's see what we have over here. Okay, let's have that sheet presented, that's fine. Of course, I just also want to remove, you know, the actual functionality into the view model. So I'm just going to create a function of present sheet, that's fine. And is presented is toggle. So now instead of is presented.toggle, you know, all of the details of what I'm doing is just hidden nicely tucked away in the present sheet function. Let's build and run once more. And this is how it should be. You should just separate away your business logic from the view. Okay, and now we can just simply remove that state variable. Every iOS developer can benefit greatly from having a mentor. A mentor helps you navigate the complexities of the iOS ecosystem, offering personalized guidance, industry insights, and solutions to challenges that can accelerate your learning curve. With tailored feedback and career advice, a mentor ensures you're always on the right path to success. In fact, I offer one-on-one mentorship to help you sharpen your skills and reach your full potential. Until Halloween, you buy one and you get one for free. The link is down in the description. Okay, that's fine. Now, what if I want to have this kind of is presented or the present sheet on other views too? Maybe I have different sheets that I want to present. How would we do that? Well, we want to move the initialization of our view model outside. But now this is the view model for the content view. I'm just going to create another one. And I'm going to use that one. I'm going to call that coordinator. So let's create a new empty file called coordinator. There we go. Let's import SwiftUI. Let's create a class coordinator observable object is presented. That's fine. Let's see if the function present is presented toggle. Okay, that's perfectly fine. And then what we are going to do is just set it up as an environment object. Let's just do that on the app file. I want this to be available throughout my application. So add state object private var. It would be the coordinator of type coordinator, and we are going to just initialize it. Well, this also works, but I prefer it like this. So equals coordinator. Perfect. So now what we want to do is just add that as an environment object. There we go, environment object and coordinator. Now we got our coordinator. Now we need to access it. On the content view, instead of state object private var view model, we are just going to have add environment object private var coordinator of type coordinator. And that will just work seamlessly. Let's just have coordinator and their coordinator. And instead of present sheet, we are going to just have present. And right over here, coordinator is presented. Okay, so now we can just safely remove the view model and let's build and run. And let's see if, you know, everything works as expected. The sheet is being presented. Here you go. We are presenting the sheet as expected. Now, this is a little bit more than just a view model because now we have access to it throughout our entire application. Of course, if we put it into the content view, of course, you may limit the reach of this environment object. Okay, that's fine, but environment objects, observable objects are kind of pre-iOS 17. They are kind of old school. So I would like to have iOS 17 and plus's observable macro. So let's refactor this code a little bit. So we are going to have add observable. Again, this is iOS 17 plus. We want to remove the observable object right over here and the published property wrapper like that. Okay, we have changed our coordinator to be observable. That's fine. Now we need to set it up. Now instead of this coordinator, we would just need to have not state object, but at state and private var coordinator. And again, we are initializing it. And instead of environment object, we are going to use the environment this one. With the object, it needs an observable and an any object. We're going to take a look at what AI suggested there in just a second. But for now, we just need environment. And we're just going to pass along coordinator, which is fine. And then on the content view, instead of having environment object, we want to have, and I'm just going to comment it out, at environment. And yeah, basically this is what the AI is suggesting. We don't have that yet. just yet. We are going to get there, so make sure that you subscribe to the channel and watch the video till the end. For now, we are having this environment, and we want to have type out coordinator.self, and again, private var coordinator. Okay, so now it seems that everything is okay, but it's not. So coordinator.present accessing the function works okay, but it says cannot find $ coordinator in scope. And that is because now the coordinator is not an observable object. It is actually an environment. So what we need to do is actually modify the environment, what we have right over here, into a bindable. So let's just do that. At bindable var coordinator equals coordinator. And now we see that all of this should go away. There we go. Build has succeeded. I just needed to rebuild our project. Nice. By the way, let's just build and run and let's see that everything is working as expected. Great, so the sheet is being presented. Okay, that's fine. We have the observable, but still this environment object coordinator.self, and you know, it's kind of cumbersome. It's fine, but I would like to have, instead of this, like we have with the environment of dismiss. Let me just have just environment. You see, we have the presentation manager, well, presentation mode actually, but kind of like this. The API should be like this. And that's where we are coming to this tutorial's main topic, and those are environment keys. So we need to create them. So what we are going to do is just create one coordinator key and then add that to the environment values. So I'm just going to pass it right over here. You could just add a new file, but it's much nicer. You know, you can just have an overall picture of what we are doing. So first of all, we want to create an environment key called coordinator key of type environment key. Okay, we need to have a default value, and that is just fine. Again, preference, but I just like it like that. Now that we have our coordinator key, we can add an extension to the environment values. Let's do that. Extension, environment values, that's fine. Public var coordinator of type coordinator. I'm just double checking here that everything is working as expected. I'm just going to go with this. It doesn't have to be public. And right over here, we do need a dot self. Yeah, let's just have this on the new line. And also right over here, we do need a dot self. There we go. Hopefully all of the warnings are gone now, and indeed. So now what we want to do is set it up a little bit differently. The coordinator is still an observable, but right over here, instead of you know, just passing along it as an environment, we are going to pass it along dot environment with the key path and a value. And there we go. /.coordinator, comma, coordinator. This is what we are going to use. So this is the key that we have created, and this is the state variable that we have right over here. Okay, and by the way, you could just move it inside the view modifier if you need to. You don't really need to, or you do need access to the coordinator as a state variable, then just go with the previous version. Okay, now let's go back to the content view, and finally we arrive to, you know, our pinnacle of our tutorial. We can use the other syntax on the environment. So environment, there we go, it's just giving us the solution coordinator private var coordinator. And because we are again using the bindable right over here, we can bind the isPresented variable from our observable class. So finally, let's build and run, and let's see that this is actually working. We have our sheet right over here. There we go. And that's how you can use environment keys in your project. Now, if you did like this tutorial, I highly recommend that you take a look at the link in the description for, or just go to rebeloper.com/mentoring if you don't want to take advantage of my offer. The offer is get one, buy one, get one free. Go ahead and check out. The link is down in the description.